Harry Styles is one ex-boy band member who's been making it on his own lately and then some. With everyone drooling over the new video for Watermelon Sugar, he's definitely the center of attention. Fans speak highly of Harry, like how humble he's remained despite all of the fame and fortune. But we can't forget the fact that he's the richest member to come from the band One Direction and affords himself luxuries most of us can only dream of. Out of all the 1D boys, he leads the pack for expensive purchases like homes, his car collection, and crazy designer clothing. Although Harry's been hired as the face for Gucci campaigns in the past, we know he also likes spending his money on wardrobe from them. In fact, none of his eye-catching outfits are cheap. Harry's owned homes across the US and the UK, and his latest purchase in Hampstead gives him the chance to create a trophy mansion, considering he already spent over $13 million on neighboring properties. Most of Harry's cars cost 7 figures, and his collection includes an Audi, Ferrari, classic Mercedes, and more. Not to mention the custom motorcycle he's often seen driving around town. And when he's taking a break from work, he loves to vacation in style, whether it's vacationing with friends like Adele in the Caribbean, or chilling on luxury yachts in St. Barts, Harry knows how to travel. Harry Styles is the richest member to come from boy band One Direction, surpassing all 4 others, and right before the group announced their split, Forbes declared them the highest paid celebrities under 30. Harry's also said to be the 3rd richest British celebrity at the time of this recording, and since signing a solo deal with Columbia Records in 2016, his bank account has only increased. His estimated net worth is said to be $86 million. What's going on, guys and girls? I'm Kara, and welcome back to a new series titled The Millionaire Life, here for you on Famous Entertainment. In these vids, we're going to be taking an in-depth look at the luxury lifestyles of the rich and famous, but unlike our other series, not everyone will make the cut. This is for those who have made money into the hundreds of millions, even billions of dollars, and are living like kings and queens of today. I guess for Harry it's an exception, but he's pretty close to the $100 million mark, so we'll let it slide. We did a couple vids like this on the likes of Kylie Jenner and Kanye West, and I'll link them at the end. As always, I need you guys to keep suggesting who to do next in those comments down below, follow me over on Instagram, and subscribe if you're new. Now let's get into Harry Styles' millionaire life here on Famous Entertainment. Skip Harry's come up story since I know you guys are familiar, but let's take a look at his business portfolio so we can pinpoint the sources of revenue that made him a multimillionaire. Of course, One Direction is to thank for bringing Harry to mega fame status. The boy band was declared one of the highest paid celebrities before they split up by Forbes, earning $130 million in 2015 alone, beating the likes of Taylor Swift and Lady Gaga. In 2014, the boys were walking away with $280K per day. Like I said, Harry is the richest member to come out of 1D, and he was the highest paid as well. Now there's the revenue from his thriving solo career, considering his debut album topped the charts with 230,000 album units earned in the first week alone. Aside from album sales, there's also the money from the concerts. Harry's 90 show world tour sold almost 1 million tickets, and the first leg of the tour sold out in 29 seconds. I'll also note that he raised $1.2 million in charity donations from those ticket sales too. Outside of music, Harry has earned money for his acting role in the war drama Dunkirk. It was one of the top grossing box office films of 2017, bringing in $500 million worldwide, and we also know he wants to star in more films in the future. And did we mention his fashion credentials? Harry has grabbed the attention of designers, fronting 2 menswear campaigns for Gucci in Autumn Winter 2018 and Cruise 2019, with both becoming social media sensations thanks to his cute co-stars like dogs, pigs, and chickens. Styles also founded the company Haz Publishing Limited back in 2014 alongside Irish accountant Alan McEvoy, and has additional income from his real estate investments, which I'll show you guys in a bit. With all that money, what does Harry spend it on? It's no doubt that one of his favorite ways to spoil himself is on his unique wardrobe. Harry is a fashion lover and goes all out when it comes to his clothing, which are mostly high-end designer pieces. For instance, this Toxic People sweater he wore on Ellen is Marc Jacobs and Magda Archer, and it goes for about 1.5K. Harry has another top from the same line that says My Life is Crap, which will also cost you a few hundred at least. Of course, every time Harry rocks suits, he only wears the best. Not only did he model for Gucci, he also wears the brand all the time, like when he wore this custom suit and shirt by them covered in glitter. Then there was this Dior home suit he wore out on the town, and some others on his stage performances, like the black glitter Saint Laurent suit, and another custom Gucci one, this time in vintage red and blue. For Harry's first Rolling Stone cover, he wore this rock and roll outfit while quoting The Clash's Paul Simonon by saying, "Pink is the only true rock and roll color."
And a lot of people, a lot of fans want to know about your fashion inspiration. and how that translates to on the stage and your music. Can you talk about what goes into that, or if anything, it's just you, it comes natural, it's organic?
I don't know if it's necessarily one person in particular. I think, music and fashion, and they're just, you're supposed to have fun with them. And I think it's supposed to be fun and playful. And I think it's people who I kind of grew up listening to, like Elvis and David Bowie and Stones and people like that. It's like, you know, it's part of the show because it's fun.
As co-chair of the 2019 Met Gala, all eyes were on Harry to dial it up, and that he did. The singer wore a lacy sheer top with a bow and black trousers designed by none other than Gucci's creative director, Alessandro Michele. Another way that Mr. Styles treats himself is by going on vacations. He may not be able to travel much right now thanks to the global pandemic, but before he was visiting some nice places. He likes to go away to tropical spots when he's not home in London or working in Hollywood, and has been doing so for years. Who remembers when he went to St. Bart's with Kendall Jenner? Not to mention, he rented a luxury yacht there, so we know he goes all out. To ring in the new year, Harry joined friends Adele and James Corden and went to St. Thomas in the Caribbean. Although the three friends enjoyed the beaches and sun, Harry also shared the wealth. One lucky bartender at the Caribbean Fish Market in St. Thomas received a massive tip of $2,020 from Harry in spirit of the new year. How sweet. This wasn't the only time Harry's proven he was a giver. He's been known to donate a portion of his wealth to support causes he believes in, like in 2018 when he gave $42,000 to help the Time's Up movement. During Harry's last world tour, he gave $1.2 million from the proceeds towards 62 charities around the world, such as those supporting the LGBTQ+ community, children's hospitals, food banks, and much more. He's always been interested in doing good and making a difference, so that's one thing I really respect about Harry. What Harry's put most of his $86 million fortune into seems to be his real estate. Back in 2012, he bought his first home at the young age of 18 in London for around $4 million. This place clocked in at 2,300 square feet with 4 beds and 3 baths and was known as Harry's Party Pad. He expanded his real estate portfolio across the pond as well, buying a Hollywood Hills home in 2016, but he sold that soon after for $6 million. Additionally, a few years ago, Harry bought an $8.4 million loft in the Tribeca neighborhood of New York City, and a building much loved by celebrities. His neighbors include the likes of Justin Timberlake and Jennifer Lawrence and more. Harry's loft spans just under 3,000 square feet, and the building offers great features like a gorgeous pool, extra security, and even privacy from paparazzi. Aside from his first London home purchase, aka Harry's Party Pad, he bought his next London property back in 2018, dropping over $10 million on a 5-bedroom Georgian-style semi-home. And this was only the beginning. More recently, it's been reported that Harry's planning to create a multi-million dollar super mansion by combining his fancy mansion properties. He decided to buy up the neighboring home to his Georgian-style semi in Hampstead for about $5 million in cash, and reports say he spent over $13 million in that same enclave. I'm not sure if Harry owns 2 or 3 neighboring properties, but either way, it seems he's working on building his trophy mansion, or compound, if you will. The latest purchase is a stucco-fronted 18th century villa and wasn't advertised on the open markets. The singer is understood to be stepping up security after being stalked by a homeless man he had helped over several months, and is building a fortress to ensure privacy. At least his homes are at the end of a super private road. Apparently now Harry's ready to start renovations and turn his cribs into one giant 10-bedroom hangout, boasting a games room and a movie theater. A major overhaul of the properties would likely cost a total of around $30 million or more, but Harry's excited to make it happen. Aside from his incredible properties, Harry also spends his millions on his car collection. He's been spotted out and about in various sports cars when he's not driving his motorcycle, that is. The singer was only 18 when he was spotted driving a classic Ford Capri 1970. The same car was found rusting in an underground car park near his home some years later, but when you've got as many wheels as Harry, it's easy to forget the odd one. Some years back, Harry spent just shy of $200,000 on a flash Ferrari California, which he was seen driving around Beverly Hills. He also picked up a classic red convertible Jaguar E-Type Roadster to add to his collection. And we know he likes his vintage cars because he owns a classic white Mercedes-Benz convertible too, worth around $60,000. Other cars in Harry's garage include the more spacious Range Rover, an Audi R8 coupe worth over $100,000, and another another vintage car, his bright yellow classic Ferrari Dino. More recently, the singer was spotted in LA driving his retro Mercedes-Benz SL Pagoda. This classic car would have cost Harry between $60,000 to $100,000 most likely. Alright, that concludes this episode of The Millionaire Life. What did you guys think about Harry Styles' luxury spending habits? Honestly, for someone with $86 million, I don't think he's too indulgent, and let's not forget the man gives back a lot. Let me know in the comments down below, as well as whose lifestyle is up next. My name is Kara, and be sure to subscribe, find me on Instagram, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye!